Hi viewer, welcome to Dream TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 3, Lesson 3. The topic it is statistical methods. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthan. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the proportional circles and also look at the construction of proportional circles. Before we go to the lesson goals for today, we are going to review the previous lesson. We look at the advantages of the cumulative bar graph. One of the advantages of the cumulative bar graph, when it gives a clear visual impression. If at all you look at it, you can be able to understand, you can be able to grasp the total commodity or the cumulative commodity. You can be able to get it. And also, you can be able to get each commodity for each quantity, for each variable. Then number two, the different variables can be represented in one graph. So you can have tea, means coffee. You can represent them in one graph. Not necessarily that it is one commodity. We can combine the variables. Number three, it is easy to compare production of the commodity within a certain duration. The reason for this one, it is representing each commodity in every bar supposed to be the same, similar. So you can be able to compare it very easily. Now we look at our today's lesson goals. We start by looking at what is a proportional circle. Now, when we talk about the proportional circles, this is the method where now we use the circles of various sizes to represent different sets of the data. So it is a process of representing data in circles, but not in one circle. You represent the data in different circles. For example, if at all you have a data that you have been given for 5 years, so we need a circle for every year. For every year, with its different radius. So that is the reason as to why we are saying it is a method where now we start applying using circles of various sizes, different sizes, to present a set of the data. Each circle is drawn to a size proportional to the total value of the data it represents. So we don't just draw a circle, but it should be its radius, its size should be proportional to the total value of the data it is representing. For example, the smallest value represented by the smallest circle, while the largest value to be represented by the largest circle. That is how it's supposed to be done. We have the data there. That is an example of the data. For example, you can have the data which you have there, the home page, the choose of other trade, size proportional. So we can have them there. Population, it was 13,859. As you can be able to see, it is the one that is carrying the largest size, the largest circle. Then we have the tools of the trade. You can be able to see it is in the middle. And that's why now we have the size being at least medium. Then the smallest one, which is 1,567. You can be able to see it. That is just a picture of what proportional circles are. Now let us look at the different ways how we can construct the proportional circle. there are two approaches that we can construct the proportional circles. One of the ways, it is use of the circles with the diameters proportional to the total values. This is where now we need to calculate, to convert the total to the diameters. We come to see how we use the diameters proportionally to get the different sizes of the data. Then use of the circles with areas proportional to the total square roots of the total values. So in this case now, we need to get the square root of the total values. And from there now, we go down to get in the scale. So that is the two approaches we can construct the proportional circles. That marks the end of our lesson. We shall continue from there, do the construction in our next lesson. So the assignment, the activity, highlight two approaches used to represent the proportional circles. That is the activity for today. The reference, we get it from the KEB 2003, Secondary Geography Student Book 3, that edition. For more information, you can contact us through the SMS. You can just send the SMS to the number. You can also get us from the through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. And you can also get us through the Twitter. That is how you can contact us. For more information, get to anywhere there, then you're going to be heard. Stay tuned to RIM TV. Thank you.